Hello guys, I am Daud. I am back with another video of remote sensing. Today in this video I am going to show you how you can export and raster data, and you can store that raster data or image in your Google Drive. So let's see. So first I will here paste some code. Let me bring that code here. Okay, so here you can see you don't need to understand what is the code is doing right now. Okay, so I am just briefly saying that this code is finding out the NDVI, that is normalized difference variation index, okay, around the region of the Sundarban. So I'll just run and I'll show you what is the output of the code. Okay, so here you can see the image has been appeared. So this data is showing, one is for like as you can see I have already explained the function of the filter date. The one layer is showing the image of the 2020, and another layer is showing the image that is of the 2015. Okay, if I come in the below, here you can see I have two images, NDVI 1 and NDVI 2. If I just off that NDVI 2, you will see this is the NDVI 1. Okay, this is the NDVI 1 image, and this is the NDVI 2 image. Okay, so here is the thing. Now I need to export this layer in my Google Drive for further processing. Okay, so how we can do that? So for that, if I take you to the docs tab and write just export, here you can see there are various methods for exporting to the various places. Okay, generally we use the drive to export our images. Okay, so I'll just simply show you the drive how you can export this. So if I click on the export image to drive, here you can see we are passing some arguments. First is the image, the most important, that you have to be mentioned obviously, otherwise you will not get anything. The image object you have to be passed as a first argument, and the rest of the arguments are totally optional. Okay, you don't need to bother about them, what are their functionality or what are their roles in the exporting, they have no important role. Okay, so but I will explain you some of the arguments that we can pass for better understanding that what images we are exporting. Okay, the first argument is the image. As you can understand, the image we need to export in our Google Drive or the local drive. Next is the description. You can give a small description of the image, right? And next, the folder. We can mention the folder name which is in our Google Drive already. Okay, and these are not required. This is the region. Okay, the region we have traced or we have created for that particular layer. This is the region we can pass also this, and this is the scale, the resolution in meter per pixel. We generally take this as a 30. Okay, and these are some like this is the CRS, the coordinate reference system. Okay, is the like is a special object tells Python where the raster is located in the geographic space. Okay, you don't need to bother about them. Like if you want to further know about this thing, what are their functionality and what are they doing, you can search in the Google and you will find most of the answer. Okay, here in this video I'm just practically showing how you can export the images or the raster. Yeah, these are the like some parameters you need to know Okay, so if I just write this, let's say here export dot image dot to drive, okay, and the first argument we will pass as like the image, the NDVI, okay, this layer we are exporting this layer, so that's why this image object, so we will pass this argument first, okay, as an image. Now we can give a small description like say NDVI, right? Next we need to define a scale. Let's say I already told you we keep generally resolution parameter that is 30 for the image pixel size, okay, as I showed you here. Where is that scale? Resolution in meter per pixel, that is default is 1000. We can manually select the pixel. Now this is enough, okay, just for exporting the image this is enough for you. So let's proceed. If I now hit the run button, what you will see in our task tab, okay, in our task tab it is showing the unsubmitted tasks. Okay, we queued a task for the Google Earth engine, but still we haven't run that task. So for run this task we need to hit the run button. Now as you can see, I gave the description of this raster image as a NDVI, okay, and this is the scale meter per pixel. We already defined all of this, and this is the file format. This is GOTIFF, okay, this is tag image file format. This image format is actually is representing the file format for storing the raster graphic images, okay. So now if I just hit the run button, now it will start exporting the image to my drive, okay. So it generally takes time, around, depending on your image, how big size is your image. So I will just stop the video now, and when it will be completed I will then continue from there, okay. So yes guys, as you can see it took almost 6 minutes to export the image. So if I just go to my Google Drive, let's see where is the drive. Yeah, here. Here you can see this is the ndvi.tif. Okay, so image is already been extracted. So now I will show you this raster image in the Snap Sentinel toolbox. Okay, so that's why I need to download this image. So if I show you, yeah, I need to download anywhere. Just see the image size is 165 MB. So you can understand how big these raster data are. Now my image is all downloaded. Now I will open this raster data in the Sentinel toolbox. So now, as you can see, this is the Sentinel toolbox. I imported the image that I downloaded or exported in my Google Drive. So now if I just expand this NDVI and in the bands, and if I double click on the band one, because it has only now one band that we already exported the image. Now you can see this is the raster of the image. So finally we successfully exported the image that we want for our further process. And also guys, if you want to know how you can use the Sentinel toolbox also, you can comment below. So I will make videos on the topics how you can use the Sentinel toolbox also, but for now I will continue the Google Earth Engine series. Yeah, so that's it for today's guys. I'll be coming on the next video with some more remote sensing stuff. You can reach out to me in my Instagram and Facebook ID and ask your questions. And if you are enjoying our video, you can like, comment and share the videos for more reach, and also subscribe the channel. You can comment your doubts in the comment section, and you can say have you practiced this course yourself or not. So until then, have peace.